Well, I'm not the person that can actually technically judge that they're reasonably safe. What I like to make sure is that the Nuclear Regulatory Commission, the industry, and others are under intense scrutiny and pressure to make sure they are as safe as we can make them. Let me say a couple things about what actually happened in Fukushima, where the water, we're not quite sure why, even from the shaking of the thing that might have thrown some of the water out of the pools that in this particular case, in particular design, were at a higher level, like on the third floor of the reactor. But then we also don't know whether these were breaking open or whatnot, and besides that, you must continue to have the water flow through to keep the cooling effect happening. The water does two functions for you. One is it cools, because these things are very hot when they come out of the reactor for multiple years. Then you have the second thing is, by just simply having them deep in the water, you can actually stand over them. I've stood at a nuclear power plant in the United States where you can stand over the pool, and the radiation, you're protected from it by the incredible water, which actually has boron and other chemicals in it to help protect. So, but this design there was particularly troublesome because it was on the higher floor. That is not the common design in the United States. The common design for a spent fuel pool is actually at ground level and in the ground kind of proposition. That doesn't mean there can't be problems, but what happens is when the water goes away, these things heat up, they flame up, and then they throw stuff into the atmosphere, which is very dangerous. So that's what we've got to protect against. Now, in the United States, the pattern is, and I don't think there's an easy way to change this pattern, that those rods that come out of, the fuel rods that come out of the reactor, which are at their greatest toxicity, those must go into water immediately. They're underwater in the reactor, they go into water, and they probably need to stay there for 4 or 5 years. The issue that we're going to be dealing with in this country is, so after that, shouldn't you get them out of the pools? Doesn't that reduce the risk? And this issue came up right after 9/11, and the Nuclear Regulatory Commission actually had a lot of secret hearings on this, and I'm not privy to all that they found out as to how easy it was to damage one of these pools by an airplane or something of that sort and what would be the impact. But the key here is you keep them for 5 years at least in that. Then you can go to what we call dry cask storage, which we believe is highly safe and indeed maybe for 60 to 100 years able to store it. That just simply is a gigantic cask. It's on up on the land and uses just air currents coming in through the thing to help cool it down. One of the questions in my mind as a member of the commission is I want to find out more about what happened to the dry casks at Fukushima, because they had both systems. And one of the questions about the dry cask is, was there any interference with the convection currents? Was there any stoppage? Was there any cracks that caused by this enormous shaking? So far, I think we've heard nothing, and which would suggest there was not a problem. However, it may just be that there were so many other bigger problems, nobody had done the kind of inspection and serious work that has to be done to detect whether or not we're accurate about this. So that's one of my questions at the commission.